The adhan, the call to prayers, was established as part of the Sharia. Without it, the Salat cannot start without the adhan and the iqama. Nida'ul haq, the call of what is correct and right and just. The adhan itself begins with Allah's glorification and ascertains Allah's oneness at Tawheed. It begins with the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It includes the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his totality, in his perfection, in his divinity. And then reconfirms his oneness and refutes any polytheism or association. And then ascertains that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the seed of the prophets and the messengers. And calls people to obey Allah. The adhan calls people to obey Allah. Say, hayya ala salat, come to salat, hayya ala salat. Come to communion with your Lord. Come to jama'ah, come to pray in jama'ah. Then it calls people for falah, hayya ala al-falah. Come to permanent, long, eternal life. Hayya ala al-falah. Falah means permanent life. Only that in success. Such success is only the lot of those, inshallah, all of you, inshallah, all the people will be among the people who benefit from that falah, that permanent life. Under rules and conditions, we pray to Allah for these rules to be satisfied by everyone who hears and complies. Hayya ala al-falah is also an announcement that there is a promise, there is a timetable that we will all be coming back before our Lord for judgment, we'll all be resurrected, we'll all be standing and hoping, inshallah, to receive full forgiveness for our failures. The first time Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu anhu called the adhan, it was in Medina, it was heard even in the skies. People heard rumbling happening, huge rumbling happening. Sidi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do you know what that was? Atadruna ma hada? Do you know what this is? They said, Allah wa Rasuluhu a'lam, Allah and His Messenger know best. What's this rumbling? He said, Inna Rabbakum amara abwaba samati an tuftah. Your Lord, Allah Azza wa Jal, has ordered the gates of the heavens to open. Fafutihat ila al-arsh. They were opened up to the divine throne. لِأَذَانِ بِلَال, because Bilal called the adhan. لِأَذَانِ بِلَال. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu asked, is it only for Bilal? He said, no, for every muazzin. For every muazzin, the gates of the heavens open up to the divine throne. Every muazzin who calls the adhan. Muazzins don't make mistakes. Muazzins are dedicated to Allah Azza wa Jal. They do not get paid for that. And they're not allowed even to get paid for that, for calling the adhan. Even Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu wished that he could call the adhan, but it would not be possible for him to be Amir al-Mu'mineen and the Mu'addin at the same time. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يُرَدُّ الدُّعَاءُ بَيْنَ الْأَذَانِ وَالْإِقَامَةِ. Any prayer, any supplication between the adhan and the iqamah, any supplications, any prayers between the adhan and the iqamah, Allah will accept them. Allah will accept your supplication, dua, between the adhan and the iqamah.